I'm so excited.
And we're excited to see you too. Why don't you tell us who you are?
Tell us your name and what country you're calling from.
I'm come from Cambodia.
And your name?
My name is Ron Kau.
Great. Welcome, Ron. Welcome to talk to us. And you know, you're our second caller from Cambodia today. Very unusual.
Oh, really?
Yes. It's nighttime there, right?
Yeah. Yes. You know what? That actually, I'm working, so I don't have much time, but today is my day off.
Oh, good.
But I'm still learning English.
That's good to do on your day off.
Where do you work, or what kind of job do you do?
I work in Walmart.
In where?
Walmart.
Walmart? The store.
Oh, my goodness.
In the store, yes.
Did you know there were Walmarts in Cambodia?
No. Right now I'm living in United States in Florida.
Oh, okay.
All right.
We thought we had a news story about Walmart.
Is the world's largest chain of retail stores, and I know that they've got international operations in a lot of countries. But okay, so you're actually calling us from Florida.
Yes, I'm from Florida. I live in Fort Lauderdale, close with Miami.
Oh my goodness! So you have all of the college students coming for spring break, right? Because Fort Lauderdale is where they're be. Is it crowded?
It's not really. But since I got a job, so I quit my school.
And which school do you go to?
I just ESL.
Oh, ESL, good.
Yeah, because I don't have, I need to, GED, finish GED, but the first time I failed.
Now I
try again, yes.
Good.
We should explain a GED instead of graduating from high school, it's an equivalency degree. So you don't have to do all 4 years of high school. You take a test and you get your GED. Your equivalency. Yes.
So you get like a high school diploma. And also we should explain what ESL is. It's English as a second language, right?
Yes.
ESL.
Yes. ESL as a second language.
So tell us a little bit about your job. What's it like working in Walmart, and what kind of work do you do there?
I work in Delhi, but right now I just got a new position. I am now a manager of Delhi.
Congratulations.
Right. Thank you so much.
So you manage other people and tell them what to do?
Yeah, in department.
Great.
The deli department.
The delicatessen.
Is that what where you do? You get lunch meat or meat.
That's right.
I didn't realize Walmart had delicatessen or deli section.
It just opened about maybe a year now. I just got a job about 2 years ago. Come this April 14th, I worked with them in 2 years.
Oh, congratulations on
wow.
on!
How long have you lived in this country?
Gonna be 3 years and 5 months.
And what brought you to the United States?
My husband.
Your husband.
Is he American or is he Cambodian?
He is a Guyanese.
Guyanese.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, he grew up in United States. Do you know what? Before I don't speak English, but I came here. I go to school and, you know, train me, practice how to pronounce. But I still speak backward.
Actually good. You're doing very well.
So now your husband's a Guyanese, so English is his first language.
Yes.
Right, and so I'm assuming he helped you with your... Where did you meet? Do you mind if we ask? Where did you meet?
Your husband.
Say again, please.
Where did you meet your husband?
It's a have a long story. You know what?
We have time.
It's all right. You don't have to answer if it's personal.
Okay. I can tell. It's not a big deal.
Okay.
He has a friend in California. Yes. She always visits Cambodia every year. So he told his friends that he need to marry with some from over there. And she said okay. Just give her time and see. I don't know her too, but she actually know my cousin.
Small world, right?
So did you meet your husband at all before you got married or before you came to this country?
No.
No. Oh my. So
you to my cousin, and then my cousin told me now we have the guy in overseas want to marry. So she asked me, and I said, okay, let me see. That's so interesting. Actually, I want to be here.
Well, that's nice. I mean, so that's and you've been married now how many years?
I'm gonna be. I came over here about like 2010 August.
Oh,
so it's coming up on 3 years. All right, Ron, you have to tell me.
That's 2009 August.
Okay, Ron, yeah. You have to tell me as a woman when you first saw him. What did you think? I can't imagine seeing my husband for the first time, knowing that I was going to marry him.
As a one more thing, I'm not interested with him, but I'm interested in want to be in the United States.
We won't tell anybody.
Just the world when we post this. But it sounds like things have worked out.
Yes.
And I mean, they're made, they arranged marriages, you know, happen.
Absolutely.
And that's...
all over the world. And it's good. You're here now.
Has he visited Cambodia with you and met your family? And...
Oh, yeah. The first time he came down over there and just 1 week and engaged with me.
Oh, so you didn't meet him before you came to
Nothing,
the United States.
But after he, like, his friend introduced me with him, we chat, like, we emailed back and forth, like, about 6 months. Have to know each other first.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then he said, okay, now everything, like, comes smooth. He said, okay, he's going to come to see me.
And so you introduced him to your family. What did your... You have parents? What did they say? Mom and dad?
I actually, before I have only mom, I don't have my father. So my mom, she said, okay, up to me because I'm not young.
So
yeah,
she left
the decision. That's why she said, okay, this up to me that I decide. I said, okay, now he come down and want to see my family. Mm-hmm. And after that, he proposed to me. Said, okay, now he want to engage.
Wow, fascinating story. I love that story.
what a nice story.
Yeah.
Wait, so tell us a little bit. You're now the manager of the deli section at a Walmart. Which is really big, for people who aren't familiar, it's a very big store that sells like everything.
Oh yeah, it's a lot and a huge store.
Yeah, right. And so what's a typical day like for you?
What do you mean?
What kinds of things do you do in your job? I mean, do you mostly manage other employees or do you serve food as well? Do you meet the customers?
Yes, so food as well. And we sell like kind of like, I don't know, because my country, they don't have all stuff like that.
Yeah. Right, the different names.
They have a slice of, they have meat and cheese, and we have like some food already cooked.
Now, in Fort Lauderdale, do you have a large Cambodian population?
Only me.
Only you.
Only you. Oh. Well, there's probably others. Go on Google, you know. You could probably Facebook.
They have one in West Palm Beach. They have one family over there. Last time I just come down here, I went to see them. They say, oh, only like their family.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, but actually, I like to, you know... I thought, like, I don't know, I always thought, like, I'm growing with Cambodian language, but now I come to learn English, I have to find people who speak English.
Right, to learn English better.
Yeah, to learn English better, but sometimes we miss your family or the same native.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
they come, you can't practice, but, oh, so poor.
Yes, but it's good to practice, you're good.
Yeah, it's good to practice, but you know what, when I just came... got a job. I don't know English very well. I don't know nothing. But when they call me, I apply by online.
Oh.
My husband, he helped me to put all application by online.
Good.
Yes, try. But the first time I failed maybe 3 jobs because of my English.
Oh, right.
I have experience in the store in my country, but you know, it depends. When you move to another country, everything start new. Everything over, yeah.
Right, you have to start at the bottom and work up.
Well, one question I'm interested in. So now your name is spelled Ron in English, right, Ron? Which typically is a male name.
Right.
And so when
I have no idea how to ask my mom.
It's not shortened? Because sometimes they shorten names.
People in my workplace, they call me, say, Ron look like a man name. But okay, whatever they want to call, they call me Ronnie. I said, okay.
Ronnie.
Right.
R-O-N-I. That would designate a girl.
Yeah, because like Rhonda, people, Rhonda's as a woman's name, and it's often shortened to Ronnie or Ron. But do people who don't know you, do they assume sometimes that from your name that you're a man and not?
Yeah, they sometimes they call it one to talk Mr. Ron and say, oh, it's not Mr., it's a Miss.
It's me. You know what I love about you, Ron? I love your love of life. You're very optimistic, very positive.
It's a very hard. You know what? I got a job. You know how I got a job the first time in Walmart? I am a maintenance.
Maintenance worker. Yeah, that was a hard one.
But I don't know what is a maintenance mean when they ask me, can I get a job? I said, yes.
Because you wanted a job, no matter
what how to job. So I said, probably, because, you know, after I learn probably English, so I can move up.
Right.
I'm lucky. I'm 3 months in maintenance. So my boss, he said, okay, Ron, right now want to move to cashier. I said, okay, very well.
Right.
But I couldn't get for 6 months. He said, after 6 months, I can apply for another position. I said, no. And then I have co-manager. He asked me, Ron, want to work with Delhi because Delhi, they just opened.
I'm not smart.
I say yes.
Right when they open.
I keep the cashier.